a certain conclusiveness about black ink on white paper. Few are the people entirely satisfied with any oral offering of the news. They want to read about and ponder over news events at their leisure, never at an appointed time. A newspaper can teach you to do everything from building your home to baking a pizza. It tells you how to live longer, be happier, dress better, invest sensibly, and where to find a bargain and a job. It can provide a cure to your golf slice, locate a lost puppy, line a pantry shelf, and start a fire in the hearth. The thud of the folded newspaper on the porch of the home is one of the most familiar sounds in America. It signalizes the arrival of news, information, and entertainment for the whole family. This is among the familiar phenomena of daily life throughout America. And this is the story of your newspapers and the minds and muscle that make them possible. A necessity was recognized for the first time in 1861. Oliver Wendell Holmes, reporting on the Civil War, wrote, "Bread and the newspaper. We must have something to eat and the newspaper to read. The newspaper is as imperious as a Russian ukase. It will be had and it will be read. To this, all else must give place." Since its founding in 1891, the Everett Herald has been an integral force in the lives of Snohomish Countyans. Each day it gives accurate reports of local, national, and world news, together with helpful interpretive articles, editorials, and lively pictures. Just as readers have confidence in the paper's news content, so do they place an equal trust in the advertising. Advertising contributes mightily to the movement of hundreds of millions of dollars worth of goods and services in the Everett market area every year. Besides being the chief selling tool for merchants and individual readers with things to sell, advertising also produces the revenue which enables the papers to obtain some of the best creative talent available. Nature produces nothing as perishable as news. So keen is competition that continuous efforts are made by the Herald to find new and faster ways to gather news. Radio-controlled cars keep all departments in constant contact. Use of radios by writers and photographers often spells the difference between a detailed story and a skimpy account. Stories phoned or radioed to the news department are rushed in type long before the reporter can return to the office. The Herald and Western Sun are privately owned, aggressively operated, and constantly aware of their role in protecting the people's right to know. The newspaper man looks the public official in the eye and asks his questions without apology. Herald reporters represent the voters too. Voters who express their franchise through a subscription. Pictures add impact and drama to reports of news events, and radio-controlled cars play a vital role in Herald photographers being Johnny's on the spot. Photographers equipped with modern cameras and the knowledge to use them provide Herald and Western Sun readers pictorial coverage anywhere, anytime. Photographers go where the action is, and often they risk their lives to deliver pictures truly worthy of publication. Western Sun photographers often take to the air for coverage of major disasters. From the time a picture is taken until it is delivered to the news editor can be measured in minutes. The photos selected are sent to the engraving department. Some of the most modern equipment in the Pacific Northwest is being used by Herald photo engravers. Pictures are reproduced by rephotographing an original picture on a special film. A fine screen behind the lens breaks up the negative into thousands of tiny dots, 4,225 dots to the square inch. The film is developed and dried by an automatic processor. The negative is mounted on plate glass and its image transferred to magnesium plates by means of a strong light. The plates, often containing a number of pictures, are developed in water. After a dip in an acid bath, they are washed again. Placed in an etcher, an acid bath eats away the metal, leaving the dots standing in relief, ready to pick up ink and transfer it to paper. More and more Herald and Western Sun pictures are being published in color today. These are proofs of color plates. One contains all the yellow in the picture, another all the red, and a third all the blue. To make sure that its subscribers are among the best informed readers in the world, the Herald and Western Sun maintains a large staff of writers and special correspondents. There are stories from a high school, a civic club project, the birth of a baby, the death of a friend. All the news gathered comes under the close scrutiny of a copy editor who checks the accuracy of details and the grammar. Hundreds of thousands of words are poured into the Herald's news department daily through the facilities of the Associated Press and United Press International. 7 weeks elapsed before America knew that the War of 1812 had ended. Today, such news would arrive in a matter of seconds, and the Herald would select the best of two reports from worldwide facilities of AP and UPI. National and world news receives its initial handling in the wire room. Here, perforated tapes, received along with the printed news copy, are assembled together, headlines written, and other instructions jotted down for the printers. Pictures from around the world are transmitted around the clock to the Herald and Western Sun by United Press International. This picture of Governor Ronald Reagan was received at the Herald in minutes after it was taken. The Everett paper is among the very few of its size in the entire country employing an editorial cartoonist. Many Herald editorial cartoons are reprinted in other newspapers across the country by special request from editors. The voice, conscience, and soul of a newspaper is its editorial page. It was Horace Greeley, more than anyone else, who developed editorial pages in newspapers around 1850. The Herald and Western Sun editorial pages are prepared by the managing editor, who answers directly to the publisher. Many changes have taken place since Horace Greeley's time, but the editorial page is still the voice of the newspaper. Editorials of today, shorter and more concise than of old, express the opinions of the newspaper on many subjects, from grave to gay. Only in America is there a free press. Never in history have forces ceased efforts to deprive the press of its responsibility to lay the truth before the public. Thomas Jefferson wrote of the First Amendment, "Were it left to me to decide whether we should have a government without newspapers or newspapers without government, I should not hesitate for a moment to prefer the latter." As the day moves on in a newspaper plant, the pace hastens. Stories are moving to the mechanical department where words become holes in tape. Typewritten words are transferred to perforated tapes. Once the story is on tape, the tape is fed into a computer. In a matter of seconds, the computer makes thousands of decisions. It justifies lines, hyphenates words, and correctly splits words where necessary at the end of lines. Given the proper instructions, the computer will accept the tapes we saw earlier in the wire room, strip out line endings and hyphenations, and punch a new tape, which will allow the type to be set in different column widths. As the computer begins making decisions on the story fed into the system, it automatically activates high-speed linotype machines, which set the type at the rate of 14 lines per minute. Until 1884, when Ottmar Mergenthaler invented the linotype machine, all type was set by hand. It was a tedious, time-consuming job. But Mergenthaler's invention was the answer to mass production of the printed word. The first book to be printed with type set by the linotype machine was, oddly enough, published by a newspaper in 1886. Thomas A. Edison called the linotype machine the eighth wonder of the world. One can't help but ponder the inventor's reaction could he see this masterpiece of machinery linked to a computer today. The public concept of what a newspaper man looks like has been distorted by Hollywood and the theater. In truth, he is not invariably the dashing man in a trench coat. He may wear overalls and be closer allied to ink, molded metal, and thundering presses than with the occasional drama of the newsroom or the bustle of the business office. Successful hometown newspaper publishing can never be a fast buck business. Advertising must be closely screened to eliminate inaccuracies, misleading statements, or anything considered in bad taste. Many advertisements are rejected each year because they fail to meet standards. Advertising falls into three categories: retail, national, and classified. Classified advertising, or one ads, are ads for everyone, and every day bring together thousands of Herald readers who have things to buy, sell, or swap. Countless other people scan them for jobs, employees, lost and found items, and many services. The retail advertising department is where local stores place their ads. From the time an advertiser decides to run an ad until it actually appears in print, many people handle the copy and assist him with the many facets of preparation. Special services are available to advertisers. Ready-made art in all shapes and sizes for everyone from the giant supermarket to the corner grocer can be quickly selected. Of prime importance to the businessman, the newspaper, and the reader is layout of the ad. It must be presented in the best possible form to get the businessman results, appeal to the reader, and conform to high-quality standards of the newspaper. In many instances, Herald representatives offer several approaches to a particular campaign. From these ideas, the customer decides on sizes of the ads, publication dates, and other factors. Many advertisers require special layouts and the talents of a skilled artist. Like all other ads, many are printed using one, two, or three colors. The process of laying out an ad is much like drawing a picture. The size of type must fit into the overall plan, and the style of type, as well as illustrations, must enhance the appearance of the advertisement by lending itself to the product or service being advertised. The advertising department prepares daily dummy sheets for each page of the paper, showing each ad's exact location. Spaces at the top of the page are reserved for news and photo content. When an advertisement arrives in the composing room or print shop, the first process entails marking up the ad so linotype operators can determine quickly exactly what they must do. The composing room is the first of several mechanical operations of the newspaper process. You sense the pressure of meeting deadlines everywhere you go in a newspaper. But the clatter of brass mats dropping into place in typesetting machines, the pounding of casters, and the whine of saws give the composing room a singular quality of its own. Here is a staff of more than 50, transforming typewritten copy into columns and columns of metal and fitting these thousands of pieces together with headlines, pictures, and advertisements so that an entire page is complete. The copy for an advertisement moves from one line of type machine to another, with each machine setting only a portion of the type. The linotypes normally accommodate four sizes of type, and where an ad requires several type sizes, the copy moves about the shop from machine to machine. Many sizes of type, particularly the larger fonts, are set by hand, one letter at a time. Once the line is formed, it is cast into a solid state. All of the type destined for a particular advertisement meets here where it is correlated with the customer's copy. Is commonly known as Ad Alley. Thousands of individual lines of type are assembled here to form advertisements. Once an ad is composed, a proof is made. This is processed through a proofreader. The proof must return to the linotype machine for corrections. Then the correct lines are inserted. Proofs of some advertisements are rushed to customers for approval, and often there are last-minute changes in sale items. Probably one of the most interesting facets of composing room work is in physically bringing together all the type and forming a page with pictures, headlines, and stories. To the casual observer, it becomes a mystery how newspapers make so few errors in printing. Nothing is as old as yesterday's news, and news pages must go together rapidly while the content is fresh. And advertising destined for a particular page are in place, the page is locked up and wheeled to the stereotypers. The page is slipped onto the bed of the matrix roller. The stereotyper covers it with a paper mesh matrix and passes it beneath the giant roller, which exerts 2,000 pounds of pressure per square inch. This pressure squeezes an exact replica of the page onto the matrix. The matrix is then dried and shaped for insertion into the casting box. Molten metal up to 600 degrees Fahrenheit is poured against its surface. This process yields the curved plate or cast, which fits on the cylinder of the press. From the casting box, the plate is lifted onto a shaver, which shaves and grooves it to precise dimensions. It then passes through a system of water jets. Finally, dead metal is routed from the page. Then it moves on to the press room. As the page plates arrive in the press room, they are literally bolted into place. With all the pages in place, the press begins to roll with a low hum, which gradually increases to an almost deafening roar as the paper flies through the various units being printed on both sides. The paper is fed into cutters where it is folded and counted. In the newspaper business, we call paper newsprint. We'll buy more than 4,000 tons this year, and we'll pay $140 a ton. But we couldn't get along without it. Without the forest and machinery, only the rich could afford to buy a newspaper, one of the few products on the market today which has increased little in selling price. The papers are carried by conveyor to the circulation room, where some go into trucks for out-of-town delivery, and others direct to junior dealers. News is perishable and calls for high-speed distribution. The complex task of supervising the sale and distribution of more than 38,000 copies Monday through Saturday falls to the circulation department. This department must arrange for distributions minutes after the paper leaves the press. Until the Herald and Western Sun are delivered to the reader, is the race against time at an end, only to start all over again the next day. The wonders of the newspaper world never cease. Your newspaper is the end product of many crafts, professions, and talents. Its features will instruct, its comics delight, its editorials remind you that the American press remains militantly free. But its primary purpose is to bring you the news and enable you to keep that news with you as long as you wish. There is a certain conclusiveness about black ink on white paper.